Okay. So this is going to be my objective for today. Basically, there are five parts which I'm going to share with you this morning. The first part about what is the definition, tarifan seorang pemimpin ataupun leader. Number two, whether there is any difference when we talk about the leadership versus management, that is a leader versus a manager, because sometimes people use it interchangeably, whether it's the same thing, being a manager, being a pemimpin ataupun a leader. And the third part we're going to discuss this morning is about what are the different types of leadership that there are there. Okay? And then the fourth one, what are the characteristics, okay, sikap yang kita ada sebagai seorang pemimpin from the Islamic perspective. Okay, and then the last one will be the benefit. So what are the benefit to the health system if you have a strong, a good leadership? Okay? So when we talk about healthcare, ini, these are the stakeholders. Okay, dalam bahasa Melayu ini, we call as a pemegang taruf. Okay? So we have, of course, the first, we are here lah. Basically, we are healthcare workers, we have nurses, so we have all the physiotherapists, we have doctors. Okay, we have also put here is also administration. Okay? We are also have or answerable to ministry. So at the moment, our hospital, or we are actually under one of the 20 IPTAs, Institut Pengajian Tinggi Awang. Okay, we are answerable to the KPT. We are also what called some sort plus minus answerable to KKM, because as you probably aware, we are licensed under 586. Okay, so university, of course, and our big customer is actually patients. Okay, government, and also our another big customer will be student, because we stand as a teaching hospital. And our job or our obligation is actually to create a platform for a conducive teaching and learning for students. Okay? So ini kita kena ingat. These are our stakeholders. Okay? Now, what kind of leader you want? You want this kind of leader? Work with me. Bekerja sekali dengan saya. You work with me. Okay? Or you want this kind of a leader? Okay? Work for me. Bekerja dengan saya ataupun bekerja dengan untuk saya. Alright, so you can see the cartoon here. Okay, work for me means the boss and the employee and the employee works together, hand in hand. Okay, a boss type of leadership means I do atas, dia pandai-pandai lah naik atas ni. Okay, so this is kind of work for me. Oh, this is who here, imagine me here, ni Dr. Siti Zainab, kayu. Macam zoo program, cungak-cungak kayu perahu ni. Because, work for me. I stand here, you work for me. Okay, so is this the kind of leader you want? Or you want this kind of leader, you can see the cartoon. Cartoon explain. Sometimes I wish our leader was a little less heroic about his sense of direction. Ni nak cemai-cemai masuk ke dalam. Yeah, too enthusiastic, too visionary. Alright, there's no sense of direction, everything is okay, let's try. Okay, assume everything is okay. And then, at the end of the day, you can see, this guy is trying to go this way, this one go to this way, this one this way. So everybody, it becomes a very chaotic situation. Right? Or, you want this kind of leader? A success means climb. Good planning, alright, good management. At the end of the day, you receive, or you get the success story. Or you want this kind of leader, a plateau. Means everybody running in the same place, but there's no increasing, what they call, there's an increasing or success. Like everything is plateau. Right? So if this is this the kind of leader you want? Now, this is leaders what we're talking about. When we talk about leaderships, okay, this is all this. You can see all people, organizational rules, management, motivation. It's everything here. But we're not going to discuss about this. Right? So first is, what is the definition? The first objective today, we need to know what is a leader. So leader means a person, or maybe considered as the process of influencing the activities of an organized group. Maksudnya, a leader ni must be an influencer. Dia mesti mempengaruhi. Ataupun ada capacity of influencing other people, so that other people or employee will follow the leader. If you don't have that characteristic, then nobody will listen to you. Okay, if I say to you, oh, do this, do that, everybody, okay, they just do their own work, that's it. Okay, so the first keyword is influencing, I took influencer. So that the activities of the organized effort towards the goal setting and a good achievement. So this is the KPI that kita set in. So at the end of the day, okay, so when the leader instruct you, okay, do this, because at the end of the day, this is our KPI. So this is what we need to do. Or even we have to mobilize the people to do a very tough problem. Okay, this is the leadership, right? And a leader must be dynamic and active. He cannot be a sleeping beauty, tidur, kan? Ramai tidur sini, kan? Sejuk, saya tengok atas dia tidur, kan? Alright? So, he must be dynamic. And he must be active. Dynamic in the sense, taking example of technology, kan? So, I still remember, okay, looking at this, siapa ada doktor sini, lah. Maybe you tak sempat. When I was SASMEC last time, there's no mobile phone. No mobile phone. So you are being contacted using a pager. So everywhere you go to the toilet, you go to the restaurant, you go outside the hospital, you have to carry a pager. So once the pager beep, 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 you have to find the next available public phone if you're outside the hospital. But with technology, you have to understand that you have to use the phone. Okay, God knows in the next 10 years, kita tak tahu macam mana ni. Right? So maksudnya kita kena dynamic in allowing our people to use whatever we have in accordance to the change of time. Certainly like this, this is the system we have. We are running away from paper, going into a paperless situation. So that's the whole thing. Because we are all promoting a green environment. So to hit for the green environment, one of the things actually to reduce the amount of the usage of the paper. So we are actually going into the paper, into the paperless situation. This is technology. A dynamic leadership also means you know how to handle people because you are coming from people background. You are working in a different department. We have a nurses, we have physiotherapists, we are coming from administration. So a dynamic leader would be able to handle all different sort of characteristics. Must be dynamic into that. And also must be active, cannot be passive, sitting in the room. Okay, must be running here, look up, down, pergi kat mana-mana untuk active. Not only that, active in creating activities to the employee so that at the end of the day, okay, there's something that you can have. Alright, so must be dynamic and also active. Okay. Now, this is the second objective that we want to know whether a leader is the same as a manager. So I appoint you as a manager. I am a leader, you are a manager. Is there any different? Alright? Because long time ago, okay, it is so long since everyone was arguing that management or a manager was the answer to improve organization. Because last time people thought, oh, manager is something to improve organization. But now, how do you tengok, I think the last 2-3 years, people thought every day about leadership. Dia tak cerita pun pasal manager, manager, manager. Leadership in corporate, leadership in healthcare, leadership in this, leadership in Islam, all those things. Right? So we talk about leadership. So do this still hold the same? Is the role of a manager, being a manager, a general manager, sama dengan a leader? Is it the same? Now, this is different. Okay, a manager, if you are promoted as a manager, a job of a manager is to promote stability, order, and problem solving within the existing organization, structure, and system. Itu saja. You're given a task. My job is actually to manage that task. Whilst if you are a leader, leader ni dia kena ada vision. Okay, dia kena ada activity and change. Maksudnya, dia plan. This is what we're going to do. This is what we're going to hit. This is what we is our objective. This is at the end of the day, this is what we're going to achieve. That is a leader. Nampak beza tak? So, a leader takes you to another level or place. Whereas if you are a manager, you duduk takat tu je lah. Because I've been given to claim on call. Kerja saya untuk organize on call je lah. Saya tak boleh buat benda lain. That is a manager. Alright? So, you don't want to be a manager. You want to be a? You want to be a leader. Because that will bring you to another level. Okay, so a manager seeks to limit the scope of his or her responsibility. Maknanya, takkan ni aku, tak mudah buat benda lain. Okay, while a leader strives to expand them. A manager performs a lot of tasks, a leader prioritizes and either delegates many tasks or ignore them. That is a leader. And a manager seeks security, whereas a leader seeks a challenge. Okay, that's a difference, right? So it's very important. Now, what kind of leadership that are there? Sorry, saya nak kena check, saya ambil OT. Okay. Ada OT. Alright. The first one is visionary leadership. So, you can have a leader who is very visionary. Dia ada vision. So a leader of missionary is a leader who brings to the situation a clear and compelling sense of the future, as well as the understanding of the actions needed to get their success. Maknanya macam ni. Contoh ni. Ha, nampak gambar yang familiar ni kan? Alright, you put yourself. Contoh, dia put yourself that we must get QMS, ISO, Shariah. Contoh. That is the vision. So a leader in this in the unit or department said, okay, one day we must hit this. This is our vision. Similarly like this. Okay, a leader said, okay, we want to become a hospital rakan bayi. So a leader, a visionary leader means a leader that puts a vision. Vision 2020, vision 30 or something like that. Alright, so in your department, you can have a leader which put a set, a vision of which direction you want to be. Okay, this is one kind of vision. Visionary leadership. The second one is autocratic. Nampak gambar siapa ni? Ni Hitler, Adolf Hitler. Okay, tengok gambar ni, is autocratic means kuku besi. Autocratic emphasizes task over people, keeps authority information within the leader type. The leaders make decisions and announce them to the group with little or no subordinate participation. Means, you do what I'm telling you. If you don't do, I punish you. Okay? No, it's one-way direction. There's no two-way direction. So this is a kuku besi. Right? Sometimes in certain situations, you need this kind of leadership. Ada Arab sini kan? In Middle East, you need this kind of leadership. Because orang Arab ni kelah. Tanya Ustaz, tak tahu dah. Eh, that's why dia tengok Nabi kan. Semua challenge kat situ. Because, yeah. So, sometimes you need a little bit of this. Right? So, what we discuss today, it doesn't mean that you are just a visionary leadership. You may be a leader, a combination of visionary leadership. You may be a little bit of autocratic. Because sometimes you find this partner ni, berat dia ni. So we need some autocratic. Kena kuku besi sikit. Kalau tidak, dia tak ikut. Okay, you must impose on that. Alright? The third one is laissez-faire. Okay, a leader that shows little concern for task and let the group make the decision. Okay, do the best that you can and don't bother about me attitude. Maksudnya, buatlah. Okay, saya suruh you buat ni. Ikutlah macam mana pun. Dan you buat. Ha, ni gitu. Alright? So this ada kat sini? Ada kan? Ha, so maksudnya, you buat. As long jangan against the akta or the thing, as long as it's okay, that's fine. So this kind of leadership. The fourth one, democratic. Namun democratic, committed to task and people getting things done while sharing information. Okay, encourage participation in decision making. Happy. Maksudnya, kalau kita set in the meeting, okay, what do you think? Okay, what do you think? What do you think? Is it good or bad? Then at the end of the day, the leader will make the decision. So this more democratic. Maknanya everybody has their input. Tak ada dari seorang, okay saya nak buat ni. You know, at the end of the day, kalau macam tu, you seorang. Tak payah meeting, you seorang je lah meeting. Tak payah panggil meeting. Okay, so democratic, there's a two ways of a discussion. Alright? Okay, so this is the summary for the these three things lah. Kalau autocratic ni, one way. Do this. Okay. Laissez-faire ni, do this. Maksudnya, ikutlah. As long as that's not against the law. Democratic means two ways. Okay, what do you think? Okay, should we do this? Should we do that? At the end of the day, then the leader will make decision whether they need to this or not. Right? So more democratic. Okay. And the fifth one is bureaucratic. Bureaucratic. Kalau dalam bahasa Melayu panggil
bureaucracy.
Kita tak suka bureaucracy because dia leceh. Okay. Maksudnya staff must follow rules and policies. Okay. But the good thing that it result is safe practice because they dah set the standard. Okay, you must follow from A sampai Z. You cannot miss, you cannot jump. That's bureaucracy. Tak ada lah kalau duduk dekat Kelantan, jump. Oh, boleh bawah. Saya nak duduk depan. Contohnya, vaksin. Huh? That's why I come out earlier. In the newspaper, people jump the queue. Alright, people abuse the system. Okay, jump bawah. Masuk. Dahlah, orang yang bukan frontliner pun dapat vaksin. But if you are a bad bureaucracy punya leader ni, no. We follow the rules. A sampai Z. If you're not frontline, you're frontline. Not frontline, get out. That's bureaucracy. Sometimes it's good. Right? Cumanya, once you have already a set of goals or set of rules ni, they become less creativity lah. Because you just follow je. Okay? So that is bureaucracy. And the last one is transformation leadership. Okay? A leader who is truly inspired, inspirational, and rouses others to seek extraordinary performance and accomplish. Maksudnya, they transform. Ada attitude to transform. Okay, I want to, when I take this over, I like to transform. A little bit more like visionary. Okay, a combination of both. But the principle of transformation leadership based on these four I's: idealized, influence, intellectual simulation, individualized consideration, and also inspirational motivation. Okay, so these are the six kind of, there are so many, but I'm just going to discuss on the six, right? Just to share with you the six kind of types of leadership that are there, right? Okay, so it does not mean, as I mentioned, doesn't mean that you transform this. You must have a combination of a few style of leadership. Alright, so now we move on. Okay, the characteristic, apa dah criteria to become a good pemimpin or leader from the Islamic perspective. Okay, so I look through the literature, there are so many Al-Quran, ayat in Al-Quran and so hadith talking about pemimpin. Okay, so this one from Al-Baqarah ayat 30. Okay, that says, ketika Allah Tuhanmu berfirman kepada para malaikat, okay, sesungguhnya aku hendak menjadikan khalifah di bumi. Okay, mereka berkata, mereka ni malaikat lah, apakah engkau hendak menjadikan orang yang merusak dan menumpahkan darah di sana, sedangkan kami bertasbih memujimu dan menyucikan namamu. Maksudnya bila Allah nak lantikkan pemimpin, dalam konteks ni dia nak Bani Adam lah. Maksud anak-anak Adam ni, in particular maknanya untuk pada Nabi Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam ni. Dan malaikat ni tanya, malaikat tanya, awak nak hantar ke manusia ni yang jadi gini-gini ni? So maksudnya kita ni memang teruk lah. Kita manusia ni teruk. Bukan hari ni pun teruk, pasal orang sibuk COVID, kita sibuk berpolitik. Contoh lah. Eh, faham? So masuk malaikat cakap, kita ni bersetablih, tapi kenapa nak hantarkan ni? Dan Allah jawab balik, sungguhnya aku lebih mengetahui apa yang kamu tidak ketahui. Maksudnya tadi, walaupun malaikat tanya, bukan dia nak cakap Allah dah. Dia, kalau tafsiran yang saya baca tu lah. Maksudnya dia kata dia tanya, cuma bertanya kenapa nak hantar, sedangkan kita ni bertasbih kepada dia. Okay? Tapi Allah cakap, saya lebih mengetahui daripada apa yang kamu tidak ketahui. Okay, that's one. Okay? Lepas tu ada juga hadis. Okay? Hadis yang mengatakan, ya, bayangan Allah SWT daripada Ibnu Majah, kepadanya pemimpin adalah bayangan Allah SWT di muka bumi, dan kepadanya berlindung orang-orang yang teraniaya dan hamba Allah, dan jika ia berlaku adil, maka baginya ganjaran dan bagi rakyat dan bersyukur. Sebaliknya apabila ia curang, iaitu zalim, maka nascaya dosalah baginya dan rakyat hendaklah bersabar. Apabila para pemimpin curang, maka langit tidak akan menurunkan barakahnya. Apabila zina marajalela, maka kefakiran dan kemiskinan pun akan marajalela. So, ini pun membincangkan tentang pemimpin. Okay, so dia banyak lah. Kalau dia baca dalam tu, dia banyak cerita all this. So, I don't have much time to talk on this. Okay, tapi ini adalah contoh-contoh yang kita boleh ambil pengajaran berkenaan dengan pemimpin Islam. Okay, ini satu lagi specifically Allah Ta'ala bercerita tentang karakteristik of pemimpin, specifically talk about Nabi Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Okay, lafadkan lakum fi rasulillahi wa fi uswatun hasanatun liman kana yarjullah wal yawmil akhir rawazatara Allah kathira. There has undoubtedly been for you in the Messenger of Allah an exceptional arrangement for any person whose faith is in Allah and the last day, and who evokes Allah to consume. Okay, so maksudnya ini specifically, so apakah karakteristik ataupun sikap-sikap yang kena ada pada kita sebagai pemimpin Islam. Okay, so mestilah kita bersandarkan kepada karakteristik ataupun sifat Nabi Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam seperti berikutlah. Okay, yang pertama, motivate people. Okay, maknanya motivate lah. Okay, yang kedua ni affectionate and sympathetic. So you got sympathy, empathy. Okay, conviction. Okay, conviction firm. Okay, raise self-esteem. Okay, open to recommendation. Maknanya buka lah untuk cadangan. Bukan kita lah. Maknanya, okay, what do you think? Macam tadi lah, kita bincangkan tadi. Aware of accountability lah. Kita punya tanggungjawab. Unbiased. Bukan setakat orang tu je. Balik-balik orang tu je dapat. Elang. Balik ni je dapat. Okay. Swift decision making powers. Empathize with people undergoing hardship. Effective communicator. Okay. Good communicator, effective communicator. And able to consider material. okay, executing the strategy simultaneously. So dia adalah karakteristik-karakteristik yang ada pada Nabi Muhammad SAW dan kemudiannya diikuti oleh para sahabat. Okay, so maksudnya tadi kita bincang the different kind of leadership, but now we talking about what are the ciri-ciri kepimpinan yang kita ada sebagai seorang Islam. Okay, based atau berpesandarkan kepada hadis dan Al-Quran. Okay. Okay, the last bit, okay, what a benefit. So maksudnya if you have a good strong leadership in the healthcare system, so what would be the benefit to the system, right? Okay, number one is of course safe. Right? So you have a safe environment, okay, safe treatment. Maksudnya safe environment ni, people come into the building, building tu tak ada nampak apa nama atap nak runtuh. Kalau you tengok gambar ni kan, okay, this picture, right? This is from KKM, you can see the seat, there's no seat there. Broken chair with sharp edges. Imagine orang duduk sini, ataupun budak-budak langgar ni. Alright, so maksudnya, a safe environment. This is one example lah, environment. Okay, very important. Safe treatment, okay, because a safe hospital is a healthy hospital. Safe treatment means everything is prescribed accordingly. The way you practice medicine is very important. Putting lines, alright, jotting down the date. Eh. Sometimes the nurse date bila buat the first line is set, bila boleh remove. Contoh 48 hours remove, okay, the correct medication. Again, look at this picture here. You can see the way the medication is kept. It is kept almost the same. They are two different things, but because they put in the same rack, it's almost like look alike medication placed next to each other. So sometimes they can create confusion. Sometimes ambil yang ni, tapi tak ambil benda lain and giving that to other people. Right? So maksudnya a good leadership will create a good safety environment for our stakeholders. Who are they? Patient and also student. At the same time, also creating a safe environment for our healthcare worker working in the hospital. Right? So that's number one. Number two, entry is this is the reason. This is the reason why we are so fast about getting the ISO certification. Right? So I think yesterday, 2 days ago, we were talking about. A Syrian officer came to give a talk or refreshing course about this ISO. Okay, so that is the difference between MSQH and also ISO. ISO means we set according to our capability. So that means to say, apabila kita ada ISO ni, maksud kita ada satu standard practice. So once we know our capacity, we have our standard practice. Therefore, it's easier for whoever our employee to follow. Right, so once I fully understand and follow, that's where all this team will come in. Okay, so they know, then they know, that means to say they will be efficient in delivery and reliable. So that's all people can go to SASMEC because you're reliable. Everything is on time, all right, everything is followed to the schedule. Okay, kalau kata consultation 10 minutes, 15 minutes, they follow. All right, and also high quality services. Okay, so that's why. I hope you understand. I know to them it's a tedious thing. ISO ni macam, what is ISO? I don't understand what is ISO. Why bother having ISO? Alright, benda macam ni lah. Because if you don't have all this, alright, so how can you convince to the community? How you convince to the society, convince to the student, convince to our customer, saying that we have the good quality service, alright, this is what we have. That's why we are very, so I hope you understand. Kenapa kita very particular about ISO. Right? Bukan kita sahaja nak ambil ISO ni. So that we set the brand. Okay, SASMEC ni ada the brand ni. So that we ensure this is what we're going to get because at the end of the day, that will increase the patient satisfaction. Because this is one of the pembangkara. Patient is one of the pembangkara. Okay. Now of course, the last one is patient center. Okay. There are banyak center, self center, patient center, all this thing. Okay. So, patient center means you look at the patient as holistically. Kita tengok patient secara keseluruhan. Not only the patient, we also look into consideration of the social. Okay, Nisa? Social. Alright? So, you can looking at the, you know, because some patient, they come from different background. They may be capable of, paying the bills. Some don't. So, we look at the aspect. Or they may have, mungkin ibu tunggal, bapa tunggal, you know. Orang anak yatim piatu. So look at that perspective. Ini Islam kan ni. Kita kena tengok. That's why it's good for patient center. And also involve the family members in the management. Because once you discharge the patient from the hospital, there must be a continuation of management outside there. So that's why, like in my setting in university, for example, you operate. So you spend 10 to 12 hours operating the patient, right? And then at the end of the day, once you discharge the patient will take some time to recover. So kalau tidak ada good support from family, you know, at the end of the day, they will come back with a bad sore, pneumonia, infection. You know, at the end of the day, when you review the patient, the outcome is good, patient pun mati. So it's not worth it. Spend so much time, you punya tenaga, energy, resources, everything. Alright, so that's why we talk about patient-centered, look all aspects. Okay, from the patient, the relationship with the family, the social, and also the how we can correlate our management with them. Right? So this is my last slide. So I hope, in summary, you know, first you have to understand what is leader. A leader must be somebody who has got influence, able to influence other people to follow. Okay, so there are a few types of leadership. It can be a visionary, it can be autocratic, it can be bureaucratic, it can be democratic. Okay, you can be like laissez-faire, means buat apalah, janji jangan langgar undang-undang. Okay, what are the ciri-ciri of the, what they call, sebagai pemimpin based on apa nama Islamic perspective, okay, which I've already discussed, and the benefit that you get if you have very strong leadership in the healthcare system. Alright, so itu sahaja daripada saya. Terima kasih.